Isomers are compounds with the same molecular formula but different chemical and physical properties. Structural isomers are compounds with the same chemical formula but different connections between bonded atoms. Butanol and diethyl ether are examples of structural isomers. There are two special groups of structural isomers. Linkage isomers are isomers that differ in the atom of a ligand that binds it to a metal ion in a coordinate covalent bond. Ligands which have two atoms with a lone pair of electrons can form linkage isomers, since either atom can donate the electrons for the coordinate covalent bond. The second special group of structural isomers are the coordination isomers. These differ only in the way the ligands and counterions are distributed around the central metal ion. Once we finished discussing structural isomers, we turned our attention to stereoisomers. Stereoisomers are isomers containing the same connections between atoms, but different arrangements of the atoms in space. We looked at two different classes of stereoisomers. Geometric isomers can be found in simple organic molecules like cis and trans 2-butene, and they can also be seen in coordination complexes. It's important to remember that geometric isomers have different physical properties due to the different arrangement of atoms and therefore of electrons. Finally, we looked at optical isomers, which have the ability to rotate plane polarized light. The type we looked at are mirror images of one another. This is because they contain at least one carbon with four different groups on it, giving a handedness that we call chirality. Now that we know something about isomers, let's see if we can figure out what's different about the three compounds in the smell test we did at the beginning. The structure we see here is the compound with the formula C11H15O that we looked at earlier. Actually, make that smelled earlier. The common name of this molecule is carvone. Carvone has one chiral carbon, that is, one carbon with four different groups. This means we can have optical isomers of carvone. The mirror image isomers of carvone are shown here. In the structure on the left, the hydrogen atom comes out of the plane and the carbon chain goes into the plane. The opposite is true for the structure on the right. As we discussed earlier, optical isomers have identical physical properties except for the rotation of plane polarized light. However, there's an important biological property that's due to the asymmetry of the chiral carbon. The three-dimensional shape of the molecules in the region near the chiral carbon makes the molecules distinct enough to be distinguished by our olfactory receptors. The receptor for one of the optical isomers sends a message to the brain that says, "I smell spearmint." The other molecule binds to a different receptor, which triggers a message that says, "I smell dill." Strangest of all is what happens when both molecules are present. We call a 50-50 mix of two optical isomers a racemic mixture. One of the molecules is recognized by one receptor, and one is recognized by a different receptor. For reasons neuroscientists don't fully understand, binding to both receptors at once sends a message to the brain that says, "Ginger root."
Wow! This is so neat. I never knew smell could be so complicated.